Hello students, welcome back to again Microbiology part 2. In this last part 1 we discussed about what is microbiology, what about more about bacteria shape, structure, nutrition, reproduction. Just recall the previous session before coming into the part 2 chapter. And in the part 1, we have to discuss even about the economic importance of bacteria. And in this session, I will cover that that part also. And in today, more we are going to learn about virus. And today our chapter mostly deals with the viruses. We will learn what are viruses, discovery of virus, classification of viruses, structure of viruses, multiplication of bacteriophages, viral diseases in plants, viral diseases in animals. Before going to learn about virus, let us discuss the economic importance of bacteria, which is left in the previous session. Economic importance of bacteria, how bacteria are, whether bacteria are useful to us or whether the bacteria are harmful to us, we are going to learn now. How bacteria are useful to humans? Can you name any bacteria which are useful to humans? That is, so I'll give a hint, like how are you preparing curd? Anyone know about how the curd is getting prepared? The curd is getting prepared with the help of bacteria called lactobacillus. This is helpful in producing lactic acid. Like that. So there are many bacteria which are useful to humans. Many bacteria are directly or indirectly beneficial to humans. So they are considered as the friends and foes of man. Means they are very useful and also at the same time they are harmful also. So they are considered as friends and foes of man. And in biomining, like microbes are used in extracting valuable metals like uranium from rocks. And biosensors, some bacteria can detect biologically active toxic pollutants. Means in the air we are having many pollutants which are causing pollution. So some bacteria, they can detect biologically active toxic pollutants. So they are called as a biosensors. And biotechnology, as I told before, altering the genetic makeup of bacteria through genetic engineering. In the as I said, a plasmid is used for in the genetic engineering for producing more enzymes and all. In this genetic engineering chapter, we will in the biotechnology, while studying biotechnology chapter, we will know more about the genetic engineering. And what are the other importances of bacteria? They are also in nowadays in agriculture, they are bacteria are used as pest resistance. For example, in BT cotton, if insects are polluting the crops, so what is happening, that is it's spoiling the crops, and so these insects should be killed. So some BT cotton is introduced in this plant. If the insect eats the plant or bites the plant, the insect will die. This is because of the injecting bacteria in the plants. This is called as a pest, because and the economic importance, we can say, as is a pest resistant bacteria also discovered. And and they are also used in fiber netting and curing of leaves, and some sewage treatments also some bacteria are used. And coming to the harmful side, how bacteria are harmful to us. Bacterial diseases in humans, if you see, there are many diseases caused by the bacteria. Tetanus, botulism, cholera, typhoid, mycobacterium, tuberculosis, diphtheria, pneumonia, leprosy, gonorrhea, syphilis, etc. These are the diseases. And the right side are the bacteria which are responsible for the disease. Tetanus is caused by Clostridium tetani. Botulism is caused by the bacteria Clostridium botulinum. Cholera is caused by Vibrio cholera. Typhoid disease is caused by Salmonella typhi, Mycobacterium tuberculosis, Cyanocornibacterium tuberculosis, diphtheria, Cornibacterium diphtheriae, pneumonia, Diplococcus pneumonia, and leprosy, Mycobacterium leprae, gonorrhea, Neisseria gonorrhea, syphilis, Treponema pallidum. These are the diseases which are occurring in humans. What are the diseases occurring in plants? Blight of rice. In the rice plants, this is Xanthomonas oryzae is a bacteria which is causing the blight of rice. And in citrus fruits, citrus canker. In citrus canker fruits, Xanthomonas bacteria, Xanthomonas citra is a bacteria which is causing citrus canker. The spots you see on the lemon, citrus fruits, if you see a dark spots on the citrus, that is the disease called as a citrus canker, and is the caused by the Xanthomonas citrae. Crown gall of apples, and this is occurring in the apples, apple tree. The responsible bacteria is the Agrobacterium tumefaciens. These are some bacteria you should revise. Mostly it will be useful for objective type of questions, bacterial disease in humans and bacterial disease in plants. That's all about bacteria, and the next chapter, viruses. Coming to know about the viruses, I want to know about what you know about virus. Did you hear any time about the word virus? I think everyone know, because nowadays why are you not coming to school or colleges? Because of corona. Everyone know this corona disease, right? Corona is a virus, okay? So now we are going to learn about this kind of viruses. This is a very dangerous virus. Now it's existing now, so it is called as a COVID. Coming to what are the viruses. Viruses are a unique group of biological entities known to infect every type of cell like bacteria, algae, fungi, protozoa, plants and animals. These are the entities like these. You cannot say these are some animals or plants or some thing. These are also microorganisms which infect any cell. Even in bacteria also, they infect bacteria also. Bacteria, algae, fungi, protozoans, plants and animals. And the name virus means venom. Venom means a poisonous fluid, and this name is given by Pasteur, Louis Pasteur. The name virus means poisonous fluid or venom, given by Pasteur. Viruses are obligate intracellular parasites, that is, they cannot multiply unless they invade a specific host cell and instruct its genetic and metabolic machinery to make and release the daughter of progeny viruses. Viruses are obligate intracellular parasites, means they need a host cell to replicate, that is to reproduce, or you can say to multiply. From one virus, many viruses can come, but they require a host cell, like maybe it is a bacterial cell or a plant cell or any host cell. That is why it is called as obligate intracellular parasite. So in that parasite, suppose a virus attacks a bacteria, they inject their DNA into that and they multiply. That is how they multiply, the virus gets multiplied. We will learn in detail in the lytic phase. I will discuss this. And during this process, they destroy the host cells, causing serious damage and disease in humans, plants and animals. So viruses are best described as infectious particles. So during the process that they are destroying the host cells, as I said, a virus attacks the bacterial cell or any cell, that cell is called as the host cell. and causes serious damage, and this and it also while it's multiplying, it is making a serious damage and causing diseases to humans or plants or animals. So viruses are best described as infectious particles. Infectious particles means they cause infection. That is the reason they are called as infectious particles. The study of viruses is known as virology. How the viruses are discovered? So first, the scientist Ivanovsky was studying the disease is caused in the tobacco leaf. While he was studying the tobacco leaf, how the disease occurred, the mosaic disease occurring in the tobacco, he studied that some microorganisms are responsible for this disease, and he was thinking to detect the type of what is the microorganism which is affecting this disease. When he discovered, he extracted the cell sap of the leaf, and in that cell sap he thought that he filtered every microorganism including bacteria. The bacteria also got filtered in that. But after filtration also, that sap when injected into the new plant, that plant also got the same disease. That means it is not the bacteria which is affecting the plant, it is some other than bacteria. He found that some other than bacteria which can pass even through the filter paper, which bacteria did not pass, but virus had passed into the filter paper, and that sap contains the virus, and this sap when injected into the new plant, the plant also got affected. Then this discovery came that it is not the bacteria which is affecting the plant, it is the virus, which is much more smaller in size than the bacteria. Bacteria itself is a very small in size, and virus are much more smaller than the bacteria. Suppose a bacteria, how the ribosome we will draw the ribosome in the bacteria, the same size even the virus exists, that much small the virus particles are there. In 1992, for the first time, the Russian pathologist Maitri Ivanovsky, while studying the sap of diseased tobacco leaf, he filtered the retained bacteria, but the infectious agent passed through the pores of the filter paper, and when this injected to the healthy plant, he found the symptoms of mosaic disease in that plant too. And next, he named it as the infectious agent, but it not named it as some virus. Later, Martinus Bezhrenek, he repeated Ivanovsky experiments and concluded that the disease causing agent was contagious living fluid or contagium vivum fluidum, that it is some infectious fluid is there, and that is what it is causing the disease. That is named as a contagium vivum fluidum. Later, W.M. Stanley in 1935 purified the sap and announced that the virus causing tobacco mosaic disease could be crystallized. It was named as the tobacco mosaic virus. The virus is it is present in the sap till that it is considered as a fluid, but it is not the fluid. It can be crystallized, that it is having a shape. That is how it can be crystallized. That is found by the Stanley experiments. In the Stanley, he purified the sap and announced that the virus causing mosaic disease in tobacco could be crystallized. That means it is can be filtered, and it can be seen like a crystals, like a not in the fluid type. It was named as the tobacco mosaic virus. And next, Frankl Conrad confirmed the genetic material of the TMB is RNA. Frankl Conrad in 1956, he confirmed that the genetic material of the tobacco mosaic virus. All the scientists are studying about this tobacco mosaic virus. They confirmed that the main responsible genetic material of the tobacco mosaic virus is the RNA. This was given by the Frankl Conrad scientist. Coming to the classification of viruses, ICTV, International Committee on Taxonomy of Virus, regulates the norms of the classification and nomenclature of viruses. How the viruses are named, ICTV is responsible for this naming of viruses. ICTV means International Committee on Taxonomy of Virus. International Committee on Taxonomy of Virus. They have given the norms of classification and nomenclature of viruses, how they are classified and how the what are the names given to the viruses, how they are named, actually how they are named, that is called as the nomenclature of viruses. Actually, the viruses are not grouped under any kingdom. Viruses, they are like, they are not classified into any kingdom because they are a little bit confused whether viruses are living or non-living. But they are living because it is having some cell structure and all. And coming to the classification of viruses, the scheme of three hierarchical levels, the family, genus and species. The family name ends with the suffix viridae, while the genus names with virus. The species are common English expressions describing their nature. Suppose an example, if you see retroviridae. Viridae means the family. Which family? The family should end with the viridae. Any family, it should be ending with the viridae. And the genus should be a virus. Virus ending like a lentivirus. Okay, that virus should be polio virus, that it should be end with the virus name. And a species is nothing but the, it should describe the nature of the disease or what is the nature of that disease or like that. Suppose human deficiency virus like that, the species can be named. So family should be end with the viridae and genus should end with virus and species with the nature. Describing the nature. Viruses are named after the disease they cause, like polio virus. Polio is a disease name and the virus causing is called as the polio virus. According to ICTV, the virus that causes AIDS in humans is classified as family retroviridae, genus lentivirus, species human deficiency virus, that is HIV virus. It's a HIV virus. This is how it is named, like viridae should come in the family and virus should be end with the for the genus and the nature, describing the nature of the disease and the species. This is how the nomenclature of viruses is given by the ICTV. Let us learn the structure of viruses. Mainly, virus contains two basic components. Virus contains two basic components, that is the nucleic acid and the protein. The core of nucleic acid forms the genome and the surrounding coat of protein is called capsid. What is the core means? It is nothing but the nucleic acid. The core of nucleic acid forms the genome and the surrounding coat of the protein is called as the capsid. The virus contains mainly a nucleic acid and a protein. The protein surrounding is called as the capsid and the core of the nucleic acid is called as the genome. The capsid gives the shape and protection to the virus and capsid is made up of protein subunits called capsomeres. The number of capsomeres is characterized for each type of virus. That is in the protein coat, I said the protein coat is having some smaller subunits that are called as the capsomeres. These depending on these number of capsomeres, we can characteristic which type of the virus it is. The genome of virus is either single stranded DNA or the double stranded DNA. The virus is having a nucleic acid at all. The nucleic acid, or you can say it as a genome. The genome of a virus is either single stranded DNA or double stranded DNA. It may be single stranded or double stranded. No virus contains both DNA and RNA. No virus contains, that is, it may have RNA or DNA, but not both. Most viruses have single or more than one nucleic acid molecules. Like that, HIV has two identical molecules of RNA. It is not that it is having only single molecule of RNA. Maybe two molecules of RNA are also present in, for example, HIV virus. In general, plant virus has single-stranded RNA and animal virus has double-stranded DNA. So, usually plant viruses contains single stranded RNA and animal viruses contains double stranded DNA. Viral nucleic acid molecules are either circular or linear. It is not that it should be only in linear, it can be circular also. This is the structure of virus. We learned the general structure of viruses. And now, viruses, what is the size of the virus? If you see, the size varies from 300 nanometers in tobacco mosaic virus. And the maximum size of the virus is would be the smallest size in the bacterial cell. What is the smallest size in the bacterial cell? The virus is also similar to that size. It is like suppose 20 nanometers in parvovirus. And now coming to the different types of structures of viruses. There are many shapes you can see in the diagram. They are polyhedral, they are helical, they are rod-like, and so they are having many spikes and all. So coming to these structures, the helical viruses means the long rods that may be rigid or flexible, like the rabies virus and tobacco mosaic virus. So if you see in the diagram, the second one, which is a long rod like, that is called as the helical viruses, and it is seen in the rabies virus, the disease which is causing rabies disease. Rabies disease virus is caused by this virus. And some are like polyhedral shape. Many plants and animals and bacterial viruses are polyhedral shape, that is, which is having many sided, that is polyhedral, it is having a many sided, that is called as the, in that is present in the herpes simplex virus and also the polio virus. In these viruses, they are like a polyhedral shape. And coming to the some are enveloped viruses. The capsid of some viruses is covered by an envelope, and such enveloped viruses are roughly spherical, like they are not completely spherical, but they are a little bit spherical in shape, and they are completely surrounded by an envelope. And influenza virus is an enveloped viruses. And next, bacteria which infect the virus which infect the bacteria are called the bacteriophages. And now this bacteriophages is that the diagram which you can see in the D bit, that is the bacteriophage diagram. And measles virus have an envelope with the glycoproteins they have some spikes also on that for attaching the bacteria. Measles virus are having some spikes which can attack the, which can sit on the bacteria, and with the help of the spikes it can inject its DNA. These are some structures or types of the bacteria. You can see in the textbook, it is there, all the different types of structures. The vaccinia virus, rabies virus, mumps virus, the bacteriophages, lambda phages, rubella virus, adenovirus, HIV virus, and influenza virus, tobacco mosaic virus, and many more viruses are there. You can see and learn from the text. And next, if you see the detailed structure of one virus, like tobacco mosaic virus, and in this structure we can see the tobacco mosaic virus is about 300 nanometers long and 80 nanometers in diameter, and with a molecular weight of 39 × 10⁶ daltons. You see, this is the typical structure of the tobacco mosaic virus. The all these coil structure, these are the proteins which are surrounded to the nucleic acid. In the center, the nucleic acid, the RNA is coiled. You can see that. And these measurements make the structure of the tobacco mosaic virus. The capsid is made up of 2130 protein subunits of identical size called capsomeres. See these capsomeres, which are, these are the subgroups of these protein particles, and they are about 2130 units, these are. Okay. And the capsomeres are arranged in the helical manner, surrounded around a hollow space of 4 nanometers. The hollow space inside, if you see like a tube, if it is surrounded by some proteins, in the same way, the tube in the inside the hollow space, it is of 4 nanometers, and it is surrounded by the capsomeres like a helical shape, like a spring shape, it is coiled. And each protein subunit is made up of 158 amino acids, and inside the protein capsid there are single stranded spirally coiled RNA molecule consisting of 6500 nucleotides. So here we are, there are in this tobacco mosaic virus there are 158 amino acids, and their nucleotides are about 6500. So if a short answer comes under this structure of tobacco mosaic virus, you have to draw this diagram, and you have to explain these with the dimensions, all these dimensions. And this is the typical structure of the tobacco mosaic virus. Coming to the structure of bacteriophage, structure may be asked as a short answer question. So this is also one short answer question, like a structure of the bacteriophage. As I said, what is bacteriophage? The viruses which attack bacteria are called bacteriophages. The viruses which attack bacteria are called bacteriophages. Phages means virus, I told you. Bacteriophages are tadpole shaped with a large head and a tail. See, in the diagram you can see the large head and the tail portion. The head is that yellow color portion is called the head. The head is hexagonal and is capped by hexagonal pyramid. The tail is composed of tail sheath, basal plate and tail fibers. You see the tail portion, the blue one, and the fibers are there present. This is this whole is divided into three parts, like the tail sheath, basal plate and the tail fibers. The tail helps injecting viral DNA into the host cell. It should land on the bacteria, right? If it lands, these fibers are helpful to inject the DNA which is present inside the virus. The tail helps injecting viral DNA into the host cell. Host cell means the bacteria cell. The head and tail are joined by the collar. So collar is present in between the head and the tail. At the tip of the tail, hexagonal tail plate is present with tail pins and tail fibers. With the help of the tail fibers, the virus attaches to the host cells. I told as the tail fibers are used to land on the bacterial cell, and they attach it, and they help to inject the DNA into the bacterial cell or the host cell. This is the structure of the bacteriophage. We will learn how the virus gets multiplied. So if you take an example of bacteriophage, the virus which attacks a bacteria, and in this bacteriophage, if you see how the virus is getting multiplied. So this is called the multiplication of bacteriophages. Phages can multiply by two alternative mechanisms. There are two types which the viruses can multiply. The two types are lytic cycle and lysogenic cycle. Lytic cycle ends with lysis or death of host cell. That is, in this lytic cycle, the death of the host cell happens. That is, the bacteria cell which is acting as a host will die, or it will it is getting lysis, means death, ends with lysis or death of the host cell. Lysogenic cell means host cells remain alive, means even the virus attacks the bacteria also, the host cell will not die, it will remain alive. This cycle is the lysogenic cycle. The virus's T event phages that attack the bacterium E. coli causes lysis of the cells and are called virulent phages. Now coming to the lytic cycle, we know that the death of the host cell happens, and this is observed in the E. coli bacteria. In the E. coli bacteria, if a virus attacks, the bacteria will die. So it results in death. So this type of phages or this type of viruses are called as the virulent phages. So what is virulent phages means? You have to write the viruses T1 phages attack the bacterium E. coli, causes slices of the cells and are called virulent phages. And the slitic cycle consists of following 5 steps. This how the cycle is taking place we will learn in 5 steps. That is, in detail we can learn the how it is attached to the bacteria, how the DNA is getting penetrated, how it is getting synthesized or multiplying, and how the they are getting released. These are all the 5 steps: attachment, penetration, biosynthesis, maturation, and releases. Let us learn the lytic cycle. See the diagram. In the diagram, the bacteriophage is attaching to the bacterial cell, and the host bacterial cell and the bacteriophage, you can see. And what happens? The phage DNA, it is transferring its gene, that is its DNA, that is a blue one, which is the viral DNA, that is. It is entering into the bacterial cell. And this is the host DNA, that is the bacteria, which is having a its own chromosome or its own DNA. And what is happening? The both are getting multiplied, that is both the virus DNA and the bacterial DNA, they are getting degraded, that is they are getting broken into many pieces, and each they are degraded, and these are again formed, they are again assembled, like you can say they are getting an assembled, and again it forms, each will form one virus, and that is a, or you can say it is a bacteriophage. And this, after the cell gets burst, the all these virus gets escaped out. This is the process actually taking place, and we can learn in the 5 steps, that is attachment, penetration, biosynthesis, maturation, and lysis. What happens in the attachment? The phage attaches to the surface of the host, that is the tail fibers of virus are there, they will get attached to the sites of the bacterial cell. Some complementary sites are there, they attach to that particular sites of the bacterial cell, and there is a bacterial cell wall, they gets attached, these fibers, these tail fibers get attached to the cell wall, bacterial cell wall. Now coming to the penetration, the viral DNA enters into the host cell. How this penetration occurs, how this viral DNA immediately entering into the host cell, means here what is happening, the what is penetration? The injection of the nucleic acid from the phage to the bacterium cell. The penetration means the injection, the DNA is getting, it is entering into the bacterial cell like an injection, see. The blue one is entering into the bacterial cell. The injection of phage nucleic acid into the bacterium cell is called penetration. And the DNA of the bacteriophages passes through the plasma membrane and enters into the bacterial cell. And after entering into the bacterial cell, like here how it is entering into the plasma membrane is there is some enzyme called as the lysozyme. Here the viral enzyme which dissolves the plasma membrane of the host cell is called lysozyme. There is a term here, a lysozyme means there is an enzyme in the virus which can dissolve the plasma membrane, so the DNA is easily entering into the bacterial cell. And so the capsid outside the bacterial cell is called the ghost, means after the DNA entering into the host cell, the remaining part, structure of the DNA, the structure of the virus, it is called as the ghost. The capsid outside the bacterial cell is called the ghost. We are learning 2 terms here, lysozyme and ghost. And here ghost is nothing but after injecting the DNA, the remaining capsid part of the bacterial cell is called as the ghost. And what is biosynthesis step is, once the phage DNA reaches into the cytoplasm of the host cell, many copies of the phage DNA and phage DNA enzymes and capsid proteins are synthesized. And here complete phages cannot be found in the host cell. Completely they are not formed, but they are assembling, like because of many phases of this DNC, how they got degraded into pieces, these are getting not completely formed phases. In the next maturation phase, these are all completely formed, like they are getting assembled and they are completely formed into full-fledged bacteriophage. In this process maturation, the phase DNA and capsids are assembled into complete virions. Virions means the virions you heard in the intermediate first year chapter. This is having the DNA. Virions are having the DNA and not the protein. And prions are having the protein but not DNA. And in the last phase, it is the release phase. In the release phase, it is the final stage of the lytic cycle. The final stage of the viral multiplies in the lysis phase of the host cell. The plasma membrane of the host cell gets dissolved by the enzyme lysozyme. The host cell breaks and releases newly produced phage particles or virus. Here, the cell lyses, releasing the newly made phages. That is what the cell is, and this is also called as a burst. Burst means it is completely breaking out. That breaking out is called as the burst of the host cell. Here also the bacterial cell dies. So it is the lytic cycle ends with the death of the bacterial cell, or the host cell. You can say all these bacteriophages are released into the cytoplasm. This is about the lytic cycle. In the lysogenic cycle, in the diagram you can see both lytic cycle and the lysogenic cycle is given. In this lysogenic cycle, we know that the host cell also remain alive. Here, if you look at into the down diagram, see the phage is infecting the cell. What happens? The phage is injecting into the DNA into the bacterial cell. That phase DNA is integrated into the bacterial DNA. That is, it is combined, that it is joined in that bacterial chromosome. And what happens after that? The cell division takes place. Here in the lysogenic, what happens here? The bacterial cell divides into two cells. That is, after cytoplasmic division, the cell gets divides, and each bacterial cell is having the prophase DNA also. Means already, because the phage DNA is also there, and this phage DNA is integrated with this bacterial DNA, and this is getting split. The chromosome is split, and both cells will have the viral DNA and the bacterial DNA. So both cells will have viral DNA and the bacterial DNA. So this results in the two cells here, and each cell which is having the bacterial DNA and the viral DNA, this phase is called as a prophase. Prophase, this is called as the prophase, and this each prophase, this one, this each cell will again, what happen? It will may continue the lytic cycle. Sometimes this bacterial cell will continue the lytic cycle. That is, each again, that after forming into the separate cell, the phage DNA may comes out like a plasmid, and again it will replicates or it will multiply, and when the bacterial chromosome also gets multiplied or divided, see again it is continuing with the lytic cycle, and each will have again both phage DNA and also the bacterial DNA, how it is multiplying. And after multiplying, the cell will gets released. The cell dies and releases all the phages. This is the lysogenic cycle. Lysogenic cycle is continued with the lytic cycle. Means lysogenic cycle, the host cell is not dying, it is dividing into two with the both viral DNA and the bacterial DNA. But again it continues, the each cell again will continue into the lytic cycle. And here we will remember some terms, like some phages such as lambda phages do not cause lysis and death of the host cell when they multiply. What happens in the lysogenic cycle means they do not cause the death of the host cell, but they multiply. That is, they are divided into two cells, right? That is, they are getting multiplied, but they are not causing any death to the cell. The phages whose DNA is incorporated into host DNA to produce prophages are called temperate phages. That is, before the integration, before getting into the lytic cycle, that phase is before entering into the prophase, that is called as the temperate phase. And the prophase is the inserted phase DNA is called as the prophase. Prophase, as I told, after the DNA is entered into the, it is integrated into the battle chromosome, that phase is called as the prophase. And temperate phase is just before the forming the prophase is the temperate phase. And this is all about the lysogenic cycle. In viruses, so we can say how the virus gets multiplied by lytic cycles and lysogenic cycles. Now we will learn different diseases caused by the virus. Viral diseases in plants: chlorosis, mosaic disease, vein clearing, malformation, breaking of flowers. These we see in the plants. Like chlorosis is the symptom which you can see, the peach yellowing disease, the yellowing which we occur in this in peach plant. This is called as a chlorosis. And mosaic virus in tobacco mosaic disease, in tobacco we have seen this mosaic virus. And in bendy vein clearing, this disease is called as the vein clearing. And in cocoa plant, swollen shoot of the cocoa plant just becomes thicker, the shoot becomes thicker, swollen like, that is called as the malformation. And in tulips, the breaking of flowers occurs. This is also a disease which is caused by the virus. And viral disease in humans, what are the common diseases? Are the common cold, hepatitis, chicken pox, influenza virus, and herpes, warts, polio, AIDS, Ebola, all these are viral diseases. Even common cold also is a disease, viral disease. And these are few diseases, and most dangerous diseases are the AIDS disease, Ebola disease are the most dangerous diseases. That is, it can cause death also. And Epstein-Barr virus and human papillomavirus cause cancer in humans and animals. So Epstein-Barr is a virus, and also human papillomavirus, or these two viruses may cause cancer in the humans, also in animals. Prions cause some animal diseases such as mad cow disease in cows and scrappy disease in sheep. This infected sheep when eaten, it causes Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease in humans. Prions, as I told, it is having only the proteins, but it is not having any nucleic acid. These are called as the prions. These also cause some diseases in animals. So in cows it is causing mad cow disease, and in sheep it is causing scrappy disease. And suppose this sheep is eaten, this infected sheep is eaten, even the humans get affected, which is the disease is called as the Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. These are the some diseases of virus. These you have to remember for objective types of questions. These are some very short answer questions which may ask in this virus chapter. What is the shape of T4 phase? What is its genetic material? What is a prophage? Mention the difference between the virulent phases and the temperate phases. What is the shape of tobacco mosaic virus? What is its genetic material? These are some short answer questions. What is ICTV? How are viruses named? Explain the structure of tobacco mosaic virus. Explain the structures of T1 bacteriophages. These are some questions which are usually asked in the exams. So practice well. I hope you understood the virus chapter and all over the microbiology unit. All the best, children. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. Study well, get good marks. Thank you.